Dear students, welcome. This is the second part in which we are discussing about motion. Class 9 Science, Chapter 8. So let's get started. When we talk of motion, we always discuss what is motion. What is motion? It is the change in position of an object with time. Now, motion can be described in terms of the distance moved or the displacement, which we have already discussed in the first presentation, but we will just take a brief recap. So, what is distance moved? It is the actual length of the path traveled or covered by an object, whereas displacement is the shortest length between the initial and the final position of an object, right? So let us take an example. What is the displacement of an object if the object travels from a point O to a point A, which is 60 kilometers apart, and once again it returns back and it stops at a point C? So if we calculate what is the distance traveled, it is 60 kilometer to point A and then back to C, which is once again more 35 kilometers. So 60 plus 35, the distance traveled by the object is 95 kilometer. Now what is the displacement of the object? It is the shortest distance between the initial and the final position. So initial position is O and the final position is C, and the distance between O and C is 25 kilometer. So the displacement is just 25 kilometer. So now you can see the difference between the distance and the displacement, right? But if an object, suppose there is an athlete who is running in a circular path, and once again when he completes one lap, so what is the distance covered? It is the circumference of the circular lap, that is 2 pi r. But what is the displacement? It is zero. Why zero? Because there is no difference between the initial position and the final position, because the athlete has once again reached the starting point. So this is how the displacement is calculated. The SI unit of both the displacement and the distance is one and the same, and that is meter. Now, when we talk of motion, we know that motion can either be uniform or non-uniform motion. So what is uniform motion and what is non-uniform motion, we are going to discuss. So uniform motion is a motion if an object travels equal distances in equal intervals of time. It is said to be uniform motion. Now what is non-uniform motion? If an object or a body travels unequal distances in equal intervals of time, it is said to be non-uniform motion. We are going to discuss about some examples in the coming slides. Now, what is speed? It is the rate of the distance covered per unit time. So, how can we calculate the speed of an object? We can calculate the speed of an object by dividing the distance traveled by the time taken. So if a body travels a distance of s meters in t seconds, then its speed v is equal to s, which is the distance traveled, divided by the time taken t. The SI unit of speed is meter per second or meter per second inverse. Since speed has only magnitude, it is a scalar quantity. Now, what is a scalar quantity? What is a vector quantity? We are going to discuss. Average speed. So, when we travel, we always calculate the average speed, which is the ratio of the total distance traveled to the total time taken. So, average speed is total distance divided by the total time taken for the trip. Now, this is an example of uniform motion. So, we are seeing that there is a car and which is speeding. That means it is going, it is in motion. So it is in motion, it is traveling, right? So we can see that in the first 2 seconds It has traveled 4 meters. So at the end of 2 seconds, it has traveled 4 meters. Now once again, the next 2 seconds, once again it travels or covers 4 more meters and it reaches to 8 meters. Then in the next 2 seconds, it once again covers 4 more meters and reaches to 12 meters. And once again, in the next 2 seconds, it reaches to 16 meters, which is once again an addition of 4 meters. So we can see that this car is in uniform motion because in every 2 seconds, it is covering 4 meters. So when an object covers equal distances in equal intervals of time, we can say that the object is in uniform motion. So this car is exhibiting, or it is giving an example of uniform motion, because it is covering equal distances in equal intervals of time. Now let us see the example of a non-uniform motion. Now in this case, you can see that in the first 2 seconds, the object or the car has traveled just 1 meter. But in the subsequent 2 seconds, the car has traveled 9 more meters and it has reached 10 meters. Then in the coming 2 seconds, it has traveled 15 meters. So we can see in the first 2 seconds, it traveled just 1 meter. But in the next 2 seconds, it traveled 9 more meters. And in the third 2 seconds, it traveled 15 meters. So it is covering different distances in equal intervals of time. And thus, it is an example of non-uniform motion. So I hope that you have got a fair idea about uniform and non-uniform motion.